Our text today comes from the 17th chapter of the book of St. Luke. And we will just have one verse for right now. Sermon that you old folks have heard me preach before. The younger folks have never heard me preach. But my spirit is going to preach this morning. And Jesus answering said, 17th verse. And Jesus answering said, were there not 10 cleansed? But where are the 9? You may be seated. We're going to take out our subject from our text. Where are the 9? Brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to God for Israel is that they might be saved. Brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to God for America is that America might be saved. Brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to God for this church and other churches is that you are saved. Look at your neighbor, let's do our drill. Brother and sister,
sister.
My heart's desire.
My heart's desire.
Prayer to God.
And prayer to God.
For you. Is that you.
Is that you. Are saved.
You know why? Because God is looking. The saved people.
Amen.
Oh, yes, God wants you happy. God wants you prosperous, but most of all, He wants you saved. See, because when you're saved, you have something to buttress you. When the world rattles you at your foundation. If you're not saved, one illness can come along and knock the whole family off of their rocks. If you're not saved, the loss of one job can make you become bitter.
Yes.
If you're not saved, just one person cutting in on you in traffic can make you lose it, and if you don't watch out, you'll end up in jail. Over something that didn't mean anything anyhow.
That's right.
Amen. I was coming from Aiken the other day, and I won't call his name because he lived within 2 miles of Mount Canaan. But somebody was on the motorcycle, and I thought he recognized it. And I was running 38 miles an hour coming into Granitville, and that's fast enough coming into Granitville. And he just, whoa, right around on the motorcycle. I said, he doesn't even know who I am. Amen. So I just followed him, you know, and got up there by the mill, and guess what? The train was gone.
Oh.
All of his passing on the yellow line, all of his stuff that he was doing, and he was so upset he had to get off of his motorcycle. Walk around his motorcycle. Amen. I still didn't blow at him, so I didn't want him to know that I saw him. Amen. I may have to preach his funeral, and I don't want him to be upset before he dies. Amen. But the point is, God keeps his eyes on us, and we will, if we don't watch it, we'll allow little stuff.
Yes.
Oh, I've seen the day that I'd have gotten all up behind him and stuff, cutting in on me like that. And just passing on a yellow line. And said, oh, it was so brazen.
Yeah.
But I thought about it. That's between him and God.
Yeah.
If God is going to keep him safe, I will pray that he stays safe.
Uh-huh.
If he tempt the Holy Spirit to the point that the Holy Spirit can't even drive to sleep, then I got a black suit, pinstripe, and regular black. I will be to this field and I will be shot. Ain't the Lord all right? You can't let the world rattle you to the point that you forget who God is. Because God is searching for saved people with a spirit, not a day of thanksgiving, but a spirit of thanksgiving. For this is
this that we are living now is a period of thanksgiving, designated by the American government and the American people. But with the Christian, with the children of God, they don't have to wait for November. They don't have to wait for harvest time. They don't have to wait for my birthday. They can be like the song that says, that just got to singing, every day is a day of thanksgiving. For God has been what?
So good to me.
Every day he just keeps on blessing me.
Amen.
Take the time to praise the Lord. Not tomorrow, but praise him today. For he is so, I got my five O's on that S, so good.
Amen.
Oh, isn't he good?
Yes.
Isn't he good? Half your fat and got stuff in the refrigerator. All from last Thursday. Isn't he good?
Amen.
Half of you did he have to pay for it, because that ain't flossy. Invited you over to eat. You didn't eat paper. I just went over and might have taken a little thing of macaroni that you had in the refrigerator. Amen. But God still blesses us by the flock.
Yes.
Ooh, my Lord. He is so good to us. It bothers me to see people just taking the blessings of the Lord for granted. Oh, my God. And young people don't ever forget a time to bless God.
Yes.
Don't pass an opportunity. Because you don't know when it may be last.
Yes.
It's like my friend I was talking about came in from another friend's funeral service, and now we have had his. You don't know when it's your last time.
No.
You don't know when it's the last time you will have to praise and thank God. When we really know God, we develop an attitude and a lifestyle centered around thanksgiving.
Because
when I think about his goodness and all that he's done for me, my soul cries out, hallelujah, thank God. For saving me.
Well,
oh God, when trouble comes, thank God for saving me.
Yes.
When problems come, thank God for saving me. When sickness comes, thank God for saving me. So I admonish you, if you're a child of God, to develop a spirit and an attitude of thanksgiving. That spirit becomes meek and it becomes lowly. Because then we are able to look around at the goodness of God in his creation, into his atmosphere, and our surroundings. My soul is uplifted and cries, hallelujah, when I look at food on the table, water to drink, sunlight to move around about, moonlight at night. I didn't say moonshine, moonlight at night. Amen. Along with the stars to give direction, even in the midnight hour. Back when those old fellas didn't even have compasses to go by on ship, they could look at the sky at night and navigate those ships until morning came and they could get their bearings. Isn't God somebody?
Yes.
Yeah, we can thank him for act, gravity. What would we be if it wasn't for gravity? We'll throw something up and it would never come down. Oh, my God. But thank God for his mountains, his sea, ponds, rivers, trees, birds, bees, dogs, cats, mules, cows, horses, people. Amen. All of this, when I eat his bread, I can't help but thank him. When I breathe his air, I can't help but thank him. When I behold all that is around me,
thank
you, Lord.
And the goods that he lay upon me, I have to say, thank you.
Yes.
Thank you must come from my lips
yeah.
as well as from my heart.
Yes.
Somebody ought to say amen.
Amen.
Our demeanor and our service to mankind ought to reflect thanksgiving.
Yes.
Our songs and our conversation. Now we make a song out of anything. Ain't the Lord all right?
Amen.
You didn't just get started. We've been doing it.
Yes.
Amen. Pray for Aretha. It took her 9 minutes the other night to sing the Star Spangled Banner. Four things. Amen. I was looking for a rhythm section to come out there. Amen. Amen. But that's her thing. They paid her to do it. And I'm glad at 70 some odd years old, she can still remember the words. Amen. Ain't the Lord all right? But our demeanor and our service ought to reflect thanksgiving, our songs, our conversation. Amen.
Amen.
And what the boy named that, now that's sick, what he named it? The rapper, the singer,
Kanye
West. Amen. Pray for it, because we don't have stuff to stand on when we don't let God be our leader.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes,
yes sir. Poor boys are messed around and let the election and other things run and slap crazy. So pray for them.
Yeah.
What they canceled 23 concerts. Mm-hmm. You think of all of them thousands of people that don't have money coming up to Christmas because one man is having a slight nervous breakdown.
Well,
that's why you always have to pray. Because as the old saying, most of us able one paycheck from the poorhouse anyhow.
That's right. That's right.
Say amen. Some of y'all waiting for your paycheck next week.
Amen.
My house don't do it. He's sick. Well, we pray for you too. I'm glad you don't have a house though, so you can increase your time. Amen. It is all good.
Amen.
Yes, sir. But many people have to wait on their paycheck.
Mm-hmm.
And when you're 60 years old and waiting for your paycheck, you need prayer. Because
yes.
It ain't going nowhere. I'm going to tell you now, you can let all these other fellows who fluff your wings and pat you on the head. If you have done it by 60, it ain't going to be done.
Amen.
Unless that was you in Tennessee last night. I sure hope that was a Mount Caleb number. For that $421 million, I hope that was a Mount Caleb number that filled out that card last night. They said, well, they have confirmed. I said, maybe they want to talk to me first. Ain't the Lord all right? So our church can get paid for. But our demeanor and our service ought to reflect thanksgiving. Our songs, our conversation ought to reflect the gratitude. And I was thinking, just like the person who wrote the program this morning, Psalm 8, oh give thanks, 118, oh give thanks unto the Lord, for the Lord is good, his mercy endures not for a while, but for forever. I called upon the name of the Lord in distress. He answered me and set me in a place of prosperity.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you, Lord. The way we walk ought to make us thankful. The way we talk ought to make us thankful. The way we praise ought to be determined by our thanksgiving. And our testimony ought to be saying, thank you, Lord. Because if a robin can say thank you, we can do it too.
Thank
the Lord already.
Amen.
Amen. You got to know that song to know what I'm talking about.
Amen.
Have we reached a place in our existence where people feel entitled? I don't say that. I bless people. I gave a guy a big tip yesterday. It wasn't big in his sight, but to me a $10 tip. I used to do a holy dance for a 10 cent tip. Amen. But he hasn't said thank you yet. And I'm going to do it again because he's a hard worker. He does me a lot of favor. But I blessed somebody last week. They were talking and they never did say thank you. I didn't have to bless her. And Lord, right. Yes. My stomach was full. My bills were paid. All I had to do was go to the beach or something. But I thought enough of them to call them and bring them over and bless them, and they kept on talking, holding it up, putting it in the pot. Have we reached a place where we feel entitled based on what somebody else had?
Well,
a friend of mine told me, be the my will reading my new Lincoln I bought the other year, I'm leaving it to you. Told a sister that was in charge of her will, make sure George get my new Lincoln. Guess what? At the will reading, everybody got something, but guess what? The lady who was in charge talking about we'll take a very reasonable price. I said, no, I know she meant for me to have it. I wouldn't give you one dime. In fact, I wouldn't give you a nickel for it. Because I know what the intentions were.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
Left one of them 16 houses, all 16 houses gone.
Damn.
Huh?
Wow.
Because it was placed in a place where it wasn't a foundation. I came out and I said to myself, much as I did for that person, and many nights and days as I spent on the highways carrying her back and forth to her beach homes and stuff, and they took my car. Some say, get up off of your duffels and get over yonder to Fairway Fold. He got some 2 month old Lincoln Town cover out there. Some of them got less than 10,000 miles.
Yeah.
Go on and get you a town car, newer than the one she left you, and look toward the hills and don't look back. And guess what I did? I did exactly that. I'm on my fifth white town car. Amen. I know what he gonna get. He gonna get another town car. I probably will, because Pat Knight is in charge of my new car fund here in the church. She called me the other day, and I guess her husband knows she called me. But anyway, she called me the other day. She said, I just saw the prettiest car I believe I ever saw in my life. I said, what was it? She said, a 2017 Lincoln Town Car. I said, well, tell Mom Kaylin to get me one. We trying to build a church. I said, I ain't asking you what we trying to do. You tell Mom Kaylin to get me a town car, and I'm doing it on the air. Amen. In front of hundreds of people, Pat Knight is in charge of the town car. Amen. You want to contribute? Go to her after church. No change, please. Amen. Ain't the Lord all right?
Amen.
Yes, sir. I will ask folks for cars now. Yes, sir. I saw a man in North Carolina of the prettiest 95 Mercedes I ever seen in my life. 31,000 miles. I went up to him, I asked him for it. He just shook his head and looked at me and handed me his car. Like that. So he couldn't tell me no, because the spirit around me was too good. But he just handed me his car. I'm going to call it tonight. Said it's my birthday, we just But the Bible said we have not.
Because you ask not.
Because we
ask
not. I have been playing with people and told them, boy, that shows a pretty tie you got on. I wish I had one. And before I could get it out of my mouth, right in my hand. What we have not because we ask not. And you're going to get turned down sometimes, but don't just go asking folks for things. But when the Holy Spirit tell you to ask, ask, because God blessed us through other people.
Yeah.
I have had family members tell me, well, I got a heart that ain't got no cheering in New York. I said, when last time you visited? Oh, I don't want her to think I want, and I didn't ask you that. I said, when the last time you visited? She got to leave it to somebody. Huh? And if she doesn't leave it to you, at least she knows she got a niece or nephew that she can count on. People don't know how to put themselves in the avenue for blessings. You got an older person in your family, call and ask them, do they have a way to the grocery store? She think I want something, and tell her you want something. Tell them, I ain't carrying you to the grocery store for nothing. When you buy yourself something, buy me something too. You just call out there. Thank the Lord, all right. You'll be surprised how many states have gone back to the states because family members didn't want to hurt nobody's feelings, didn't want to step up. They can't tell you nothing but yes or no or none of your whatever kind of business. That's all they can tell you. I'm through with that. That wasn't part of my sermon.
All right.
But we've reached a place in our existence where the body language does not say thank you. There's no humility in the body language of people. People stand out asking for rides and asking for work like you're supposed to stop, like him. And boy, them gals in Atlanta crazy. You stop at a stop sign, boy, they swarm your car. Say, give me some money. Give me some money. You driving this pretty car. That woman came over to my house about 2 years ago. I want to live in something like you live in. I want to drive what you drive. And you mean you can't buy none of what I'm selling? I say, I don't need what you say. Maybe the house next door needs it. She got mad with me. Because we have that entitled mentality. Selfish and proud. Don't be dismayed. There have been unthankful people since the very beginning. David had some proud sons who were not thankful that they were the sons of the king. Solomon had proud sons that tried to overthrow what their daddy had built up. So did Eli. To the point that God sent a lad by the name of Samuel to tell Eli, because you have refused to constrain your sons, God is going to do a thing down in Israel. Parents die, children fall out, rather than being gracious and thankful in dealing with each other and their inheritance of from the earlier generation. Our text in the 17th chapter of the book of St. Luke starts at the 11th verse. Look down there at verse 11 to 13. And it came to pass as Jesus went to Jerusalem that he passed through the midst of Samaria and Galilee. And as he entered into a certain village, there met him 10 men that were lepers, or had the leprosy, and they stood all afar. And they lifted up their voices and said, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. The 10 lepers stood afar off, for they were unclean. Back in those days, certain diseases, you had to holler and tell folks, I'm coming through, unclean. In fact, they do it in some parts of the world even now. They have to holler. In India is one in particular. They have to holler that they are unclean. If they are of a low estate, they have to holler, unclean. And that means that they have to cross the street. They don't even cross the street on the same side as their compadres. They could not intercourse with society. They had bylaws that kept them isolated, intimidated them, made them outcasts in the remainder of society. In other words, their lives were over, for they had a bad disease. But they lifted up their voices and called on Jesus, saying, "Master, have mercy on us." Let me put a pin right there. Where would we be without God's grace and mercy? His forgiveness, his healing, his anointing, his saving. Thank you, God. Isn't the Lord all right?
Yes.
Then look at the first verse. And when he saw them, he said unto them, "Go your, show yourselves unto the priests." And it came to pass that as they went, they were cleansed, or they were healed. God have mercy. Just one word from Jesus. Just one word from the Master. Cleansed them, healed them, and restored them. And one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back and with a loud voice glorified God and fell down at the feet of Jesus on his face, giving thanks, and he was a Samaritan. And Jesus said unto him, "Were there not 10 of you cleansed?" And I'm sure the man said, "Yes, sir." Where are the 9? Where are the 9? We have pews in our church this morning that's empty because the 9 have not shown up. God blessed all of them. Some of them on the road trying to get back to a job didn't think it necessary to praise God. Didn't think it necessary to come by the house of worship. Some members thought it was necessary to stay home and fix them a meal and give them a lunch for the road. But no thanks to the Master that brought them down from New York, Cincinnati, Detroit, or wherever they came from. And the same God is going to get them back safe in spite of their non-faithful attitude. Unthankful, in spite of their non-worshipful spirit. Where are the 9? Where are the 9? When you get ready to clean off around the church, when you get ready to go on mission outings, where are the 9? Ain't got time. Wanna watch the football game? Wanna hug the baby? Wanna walk the dog? Anything but praising God. If it wasn't for God, you wouldn't even have that ugly dog. When you walk with the dog, you ought to say thank you. Somebody ought to say amen.
Amen.
Ain't the Lord all right?
Yes.
Oh, yes. I'm almost through. Verse 18, there are not found that return to give glory to God. Only this strange. You think of the thousands of dollars we've given to him. People just pass it through. You say, "Well, we didn't give but $20. You keep on giving $20. Just keep on handing out $20. That's why it's 100, that's why it's 500, that's why it's 1,000. Never do we get a card that say, "I got to Kentucky." All of them going to Kentucky. I can't figure out how that is. Head to Kentucky and ain't got no job. They get to Kentucky and they forget all about who gave the gas money. Forget that. We used to give out tens of thousands of dollars when I was pastor in Montmorency and scholarships from the Star Branch Association. Sometimes we'll have 100 recipients. And we'll get one left, or two left. Maybe every 10 years, one child will come to the association and stand up and say, "I just want to thank y'all for all this." The entitled! When Trump take back them Obama phones, it ain't gonna make me sad not one bit. Let them go get their telephone. Government ain't ain't got nobody business giving nobody no telephone. 250 minutes, and then if it cut off on 249, they go down there with their head right long on to cuss somebody out because they missed 1 minute. They ain't paid for nothing. God wants folks who will roll their sleeves up. Get out and say, for God I live, for God I die. I'm going to plant these seeds. All that I have left, I'm going to give them to somebody. Times another. You belong to God. Through your mom and daddy. Your mom and daddy might owe you something. I don't know about that owe you nothing. I'm looking at society like they owe you something. Show your thankfulness by being resourceful. And Jesus said unto him, do what? Arise, go thy way, for thy what?
Faith
has made thee whole. Well, the nine. Some of us have been at the plant 30 years and more. How many times do we sit at the plant? A card of faith. Doesn't have to be a card, but do something. Still trying to get off early as you can. I'm going to get out of here by 3 o'clock. Don't ever thank the man that hired you. Don't ever thank the people that supervise you for being good to you. Well, the man! Aunts, uncles have sent thousands of dollars through the mail to A&T South Carolina State, Clemson University of South Carolina, and the recipients in many cases never pick up a card to say thank you. They and the family. I'm going to see them Christmas. We're going to eat over their house, getting more and more. We're going to eat over their house. Be thankful.
Yes.
Be thankful.
Yes.
Be thankful.
Yes.
Be thankful, not in words, but in deeds. Be thankful.
Amen.
In attitude, be thankful.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Just as I am, without one plea. Well, Jesus died on the cross. Do y'all ever sin for God's sake? Say thank you for dying for me.